guys, what's going on? Look who's here. What?
We mukbanging up in this bitch.
You ever been telling what you're eating? You just start eating.
This was the crab.
Crab fried rice.
Fried rice.
And that.
And the chicken rice. But the crab fried rice needs some little spice. Honey, baby love, sugar pie. Can I get some hot sauce?
And I got some, this is chicken and shrimp dumplings.
It smells crabby.
That's the rice.
Frank's Red Hot. I put that shit on everything.
I hear hilarious. This is from a place called Thai Holic. It's in Brooklyn, New York. You leaving?
Yeah, I'm guessing.
You said it smells crabby.
That's at least my problem.
Oh, boy.
This has soy sauce. So I thought we, you know, I've been trying to do a mukbang with Carlos for a minute. You know, informal and chit-chat. You remember some vibrant conversations. And, you know, this is more casual and just kick back, relax, talk, and, you know.
So you can tell my wife, Peter.
So the last one was talking about dating and the question, you know, posed to me. I was like, it'd be fun to talk about, you know, this different perspective. But basically the question was, what do you think about dating and the first impression? Like, what is, like, your first impression? Like, putting your best foot forward. Like, what is your idea of that?
What is the idea of your best?
Putting your best foot forward. Your best foot forward.
On the first date. Or dating on the whole.
Well, I took it from dating on the whole because how I said it is, like, I believe your first impression starts from when we start speaking, not from when I first meet you to go out to eat. Because in order for me to go out with you, you got to make an impression.
Well, that depends. You see, then for some people who meet on... meet on the level of on a site, you tend to exchange numbers and there's a little casual, hi, how you doing, nice to meet you, blah, 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 my name is blah blah blah. But if it's an arranged, like a blind date setup, you wouldn't necessarily talk before the date unless that's how you work it out.
I mean, in that situation, but
how either which way, once you enter the gateway of conversation, it should be you speak your truth from day one. But again, you can't wait till you go on a first date to speak your truth. You should be speaking the truth from the jump within yourself.
All right.
Some people then say, well, I don't want to tell this new person everything because I don't know them. I don't know them yet.
We're talking about your first impression, like.
But that's the first impression for some, for them to say, well, I don't want to tell you everything that I'm dealing with or who I am, because you can't. Sometimes you can't learn that within one date.
True.
But I think the honesty should be from the jump start. What you want, what you don't like, and not just say it, but as the days and months and weeks go by, you're actually showing it.
So when you first, when your first date with your husband, how was that? If you can remember back that far.
He actually was auditioning for one of the photo shoots I was doing after the fashion show. And again, he was young. I mean, never really thought anything would have happened because, truth to be told, I was in another relationship, which wasn't... I wouldn't say it wasn't my best. It didn't bring out the best in me.
Or the relationship you were in.
Yeah.
Okay.
So after meeting him and reevaluating the relationship I was in, he posed a question once where, you know, if you can do better, why stay in it? And better doesn't mean, you know, somebody else have more money or somebody else... is more cuter or, you know, six-pack and fat ass. It's just simply better in the sense of what you desire, how someone treats you, you know, other than they take you for granted and not show their best or give their best. So, you know,
You missed out on meeting
Julio. No, we hit it off. I mean, the first couple of conversation is that I like honesty. Don't say it and don't mean it.
And this is what, on the day or before?
This was while talking, while getting to know each other. So date wasn't...
So date didn't happen. The date for me was,
we were on a photo shoot. Okay. So it was business, all business, you know. I need the models here, I need the models there, get the photo shoot done.
Okay.
But after the photo shoot, and there's that high, and I had a good time, it was okay.
Oh, so you considered the photo shoot was your first date?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Not your first meeting, your first date.
The first meeting is the day before the photo shoot when I met him at his house.
Okay.
Because he was underage, at the time he was 17, I had to meet his mom to get permission for him to be on the photo shoot.
Okay.
So, you know, again, never thought we would be here now, years later. But it was for the best.
So what do you consider a date? Has it changed from then till now?
Yeah. Because some people might go out for drinks and then call it a date.
Okay.
I would say some people mean a person. You're not going out. I might in my head think it's a date. You might think we're just hanging out. We're just chilling.
Right.
You know, and I think those terms becomes more...
Can I have the hot sauce?
Can I have the hot sauce, right?
It tastes like saltfish.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like saltfish.
You know, most people don't say what they mean and mean what they say. They tend to play the role. They play the, you know, fairly shy role. I can't reveal myself completely. But in the meantime, when you dig deep, they're shallow. There's nothing to really... To share, you know, your story is not necessarily unique. It's just coming from a different perspective. There's 101 people that have been through breakup and makeups.
I think everyone has experienced that. So it's like,
for you to think that that is so deep and so sacred, like, please.
As far as, like, when you go out, who do you think should pay? Not going from now to, I mean, you could do from when, you know, before you were married.
The first date is, I don't know you like that. You pay your bill, I pay mine.
So that's what, I mean, when you officially went on your first actual go out, that's how it was?
No, but for some people, it's, for me, with some people, it was that way.
Okay.
For me and him, I outfit the bill because I already had that discussion. I'm taking you out.
See, it's a discussion. That's what I said. See, The chicken is, that's good.
It's orgasm in your mouth. Nice chicken. It's not typical fried chicken.
When it comes to, how do you feel about sex happening on a first date?
Been there. Done that.
Do you like, okay, if some, like, you was giving someone advice and they asked you that, you know, like, say your son was at that age and, you know, how would you tell him? Yeah, how would you have that discussion?
It would simply be a sign. If you choose to have sex,
be safe,
but plan ahead. Bring your own condom.
Okay.
Don't trust them. So, you know.
Do you think it's a good thing or a bad thing? Like, for, you know, if you had to, if you was, could say, okay, you say, you know, if you're going to be safe, plan, bring your own. But if you were to give, like, would you rather he... not on the first, or even though it's a choice that sometimes happens, I get it.
I would rather him have control of himself other than fall into just the physical attraction and the desire. Mm-hmm. some people, automatic sexual attraction is there and the tension is there because they haven't had sex in a while, or, you know, they're just, that's their emotions on fire. But how many, question is, how many one night stands that you can really remember that person? And even if it was a first date, mm-hmm. your intention is like, there's something about him or her
that makes you,
that, your voice, I don't know, I don't know if I can deal with you. You had sound good on the phone, but in person, you're kind of, ooh, that gap between your two.
But you would have seen the gap before.
No.
Yeah, you would have seen the gap before.
If it's a, it depends on how we met.
Yeah, but
if I met you on the side.
If I met you on the side, I mean, forget that.
And you're not smiling in the picture, you're giving.
Well, you know, I've done, what I've seen people smile like, they're always smiling. I've said something like, do you smile? I've said something like, do you smile? Do you have any pictures? Or like, if they only have pictures like up here,
mm-hmm.
do you have a full body picture?
Mm-hmm. There's tricks
and
there.
People will get offended. Like, no, I show my full body. I want to see what I work on.
What you advertising?
Like, yeah, no.
So from
no.
the top, she can't, she showed that sexiness. I didn't know she was wide. Until she come out of the cab, and the cab ease up off the ground.
And I ain't say nothing's wrong with that, but let me know.
Be honest with your stuff. Yeah.
Let me, because my thing is, if people who do that, I think you're ashamed of yourself.
You have one peg leg.
You're still, you're ashamed of yourself.
But there are people that honestly hide their full story because they're ashamed or feel as if they would be rejected.
But then, but that thing, and you should not, you're not ready for dating.
You shouldn't be
yet.
On the website. You're right.
You're not ready for dating yet, because mm-hmm. I can't, you still trying to deal with that, then you're going to bring me into it and I have to help you deal with that. I'm not here for that. And I'm not saying that, you know, when you meet somebody, there's not going to be insecurities along the way and stuff mm-hmm. that you have to build each other up, but I can't start there. Mm-hmm. I can't start there.
Well, I should tell you, before we have sex, I have a third nut.
Some people might like that, you know, but you gotta tell them.
I have a nipple right below the left one. Honesty, again, the world is not necessarily honest.
And a lot of people say they're not gonna say that because it's not necessarily we gonna have to be intimate, so why should I let you know? Yeah. Because if it don't work out, then you know my business already.
Yeah.
But my whole thing is like, okay, so then do we wait like 6 months in? That's when you wanna be honest?
Ta da!
Nah, yo, I'm good. No, I don't.
Wait. Did I just see a six toe?
Would that turn you off? A six toe? What? I don't want to pick the baby. Why? It's their toe. It's the toe. They would have told got to do it anyway.
If you told me, don't just jump in.
Okay.
Because next you know, we're about to get the dude done. And all of a sudden, you're going, I just like when you suck my toes. And
I mean, if
For those who have six toes, it's all good.
Just
it's a blessing. Just tell your truth.
What do you think the difference is between? Okay, you meet somebody. What's the difference? What do you think the difference is between talking to someone and dating somebody?
Most people think talking, I would think talking is dating. Some people don't.
That's how I feel.
If you want to say that we're not dating and we're getting to know each other,
then there will be
friends. What's the time period? Because that means no sex.
Right.
Because I'm getting to know you.
Right, so.
Sex is intimate.
Right.
So that should be, at least for some people, it's intimate. For some people, they fuck anything that move. And I'm not saying that's wrong or right.
But they can't share their heart mm-hmm. or their truth. I don't get
because
that.
They hide behind the physical.
You're free with the sex, but you can't. I don't understand that.
Oh, you're the best shit. Mm.
I don't get
you're
that.
You're the best since. Mm. But oh my God.
Mm. Yeah.
I have something to tell you. What, 6 months later? Is now you're telling me that you came out of this situation? No, like, shouldn't you be sharing that situation with me from day one about what you like, your dislikes, what you've been through, how you've been through it. And sometimes it's necessary to share. It's necessary to share what you've been through in the sense of your exes, because it's also lessons for me to learn
about you
and apply it as I get to know you.
Right. So we don't. So if you don't want
me to slap you because you piss me off, then I would have to hold my hands before I box you because you piss me off. But, you know, jokingly about physical. But I think some people, I know someone who don't like whoever they're dating or people period around them use profanity. So it's kind of difficult with me and her because I cuss some days.
Yeah. But those are things that you should say, like, you know, I don't like cursing and stuff, yeah. So it's not a turn off.
And, you know, some people don't like when you raise your voice. You know, you're talking down to me or, you know, and I get that too, but some people are just too fucking sensitive. You know, it's like, I should govern how I behave to make you comfortable, but you're not willing to do the same. Yeah. So, okay, you don't like when they cuss, but you wait until 6 months later to tell me, say, you've been with 50 men. If I have asked in the past, so how many people have you been with? How many people you dated? Oh, I've just had, you know, two guys. Okay. 6 months later, we've been going out clubbing 2-3 times. We've already gone to brunch a couple of times. And we see people that always come over to you. How you doing? Oh, that's a friend of mine. To only find out that the truth comes back later on where one of them same people know me. And end up coming back to say, oh, you know, I dated them. What do you mean dated? You mean you went on a dinner date? Or was it sex? Oh, I had sex with them. But they told me that I only been with two people. How the f-
Slowly start letting it out. And then, I guess they're afraid. A lot of people, some of them are afraid of being judged. But my thing is, we all judge each other. Let's be honest. We judge each other.
And if I'm going to get to know you and I can't handle your truth, maybe that's not meant for us to be together.
Exactly.
But give me that option. So with you getting to know someone, what's your pet peeves?
It depends on the person. Nah, seriously though. My pet peeves, okay.
Do you like a liar?
Who likes a liar?
Some people just don't want to hear the truth.
No, I don't like a liar. I always say, be who, because my thing is either I'm going to like you or I'm not. So just be honest. You know, like I would say, like, if you're just looking for sex, just tell me you're looking for sex. Mm-hmm. If you need someone to help pay your bills, let me know what you're looking for. Because then it gives me an option to be like, okay, I'm going to mess with you. I'm not going to mess with you. Excuse me. I don't, my pet peeves, okay. I think just to cover.
Snoring.
But if I'm dating somebody, but it's not, okay, because I'm on
the same. Sometimes they spend the night.
No, because I'm the same way. The talking and dating thing, if I'm getting to know, it's like, I'm getting to know you, and then we move into dating. Because this whole talking thing, because how I'm going to be talking to you and we doing dating shit, that don't work. That's confusion. But anyway, I don't like a person that's just not ready.
Most of them is not.
A person that's just not ready. And my thing is, that covers everything. A person that's just not ready. So I can't really pin, again, because it'd be an individual, different thing. It's a person, you have to just be, if you're just ready, if you just attempt to work at something.
Ooh. What was your best relationship that didn't work and the worst one that stayed too long?
The best one that didn't work?
Mm-hmm.
Are you telling me you have a name?
No.
Oh.
But you can identify the person. Okay, you can. I would say I grade people in my head.
The best one that didn't work.
Had potential but didn't know it. And didn't utilize the opportunity to evolve.
So you want me to say a name or what? How you want me to identify it?
Give initials.
Are you stupid? No. You silly.
Give a nickname.
No, but my whole thing is
she
like,
was Pussycat.
You saying the greatest? I can't say that's a very strong word there. One that I saw possibility in and it didn't work, the initials CC. That's it. Now, what was the second option?
That's Carlos Carter.
Shut up. What's the other? Shut up. What's the other? What's the second question? The what? The worst? What's that?
The worst that lasts too long.
That's a whole lot of initials. I'm not this bad. The worst. The worst. I can't say I've had a worst, you know.
Listen, some lessons you don't need to repeat 6 months down the road. Or 6 months back to back with the same individual.
I can't say the worst. Those are too strong. The worst. That's too long.
You regret it. That's why it's the worst. I wasted 6, 7.
But you know something. I can't say I can't regret
3 years of my life with you. You're a fucking waste.
Nah, I can't say that. Honestly, I don't regret anyone because I learned from. I can't say regret.
I learned from the first month that you was a fuck up. The bottom line is you keep on begging for a chance and a chance and a chance. And here we are 2 years later. And it says I should have followed my instincts from the jump. You know somebody like that. Like I've said in other videos, we have dated people for 6 months that should have been one night stands. And one night stands that we should have given that chance for 6 months. Because that one night stand, you might never like how them walk. Their foot was crooked. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, but I just really...
Their head wasn't shaped too overly. And you were that picky. Her wig wasn't on point.
Like the last woman I was talking to, I wish, you know, there was possibility there. Because the thing is, you know, they would, you know, say all the things that they would like, mm-hmm. but they never acted on it. And then when I stepped off, then it's like, oh, okay, you know, I missed all of this, all of how you treated me. I'll take more time off work. No. I wasn't actually. I love a woman that have a job. That's not the issue. It's just when you have the time,
make time.
It's make time. You know, you can't. I'm sorry. It's like work. You want to do work and go to church, but you want to date. How does that work? Like, and I had no problem with you working, had no problem with you, Jesus, no problem. But you want a date, so you have to be present.
That's another question. Is there a conflict with your Jesus that have a, you know, that says certain things about your life that you do? Yes, we're all sinners, but you're deeply involved in church. And yes, we could take away saved by grace. But there has to be, the way some people are super religious, mm-hmm. there has to be some battle within that is not allowing you to enjoy being gay to your fullest potential.
Well, okay, she's not present, but I'm going to speak on just an experience that I experienced with her in a short time. Mm-hmm. Again, she loved church and... You know, the people in the church don't know about her. She didn't, like, I wouldn't be invited because her mother goes there. And
which is a red flag from day one.
Right, which is something that bothered me, even though
you were willing to work through it.
I was willing to work through it, but the fact to know that, okay, we going along, and okay, I would never be able to be a part of that part of your life. Mm-hmm. And I still ain't got time, you still ain't making time for me, so it's like, what the fuck? Like, what am I doing here? Mm-hmm. You know, it doesn't make sense. I mean, they really in the church. They just became an evangelist. So I said, well, I'll be first lady, first person. So it's like, you so heavily into church, which is great. But again, how you have no balance. It's like, excuse me, you have no balance. There's no room. There's no room for me. You're telling me there's room, but there's no room. So like, what the fuck you want me to do?
I can say this, right? And me and the some of the ladies. Hey, ladies. From my son's school, you know, some of them tease me about my faith, but I say that I'm not religious. Mm-hmm. I say that I'm a spiritual individual who is not governed by religion because I've I think that religion teach separation. We're separate. Mm-hmm. Spirituality teach that we are all connected somehow. Even if you don't fully understand the connection, we are all connected. Mm-hmm. Your hurt is my hurt. My hurt is your hurt. But, you know, for someone who is religious and the God, and God says not to do and God says to do and we got to do it this way. Yes, I slip and fall sometimes, but God knows my heart and it's not my intentions. Here comes the thing. Other questions for the religious individuals. When you put down the Bible and decide to lift up your legs and tell me that's the best sex you've ever had, where is the conflict? After the sex? After you nut? After you go, oh, Jesus! Coming in a Honda. When do you then deal with that conflict? Because this is a conflict. Because you, if I can't walk into church with you and you announce who I am...
Because she's, her thing is that, you know, it, like, I guess bring embarrassment to her mom. Which partly I can understand, but my partly I understand that my thing is be a part of somewhere where then you're welcome.
No, because she is validated by, hello, that church.
That's her home church.
But again, that church bring validation. So some people, it's like a bad relationship. Mm-hmm. They stay in it in spite of they're not getting 100% of what they want.
Okay, I can understand that.
You know, we need to be on. Listen, when you're 16, you have no other choice than to go to your mama church.
Okay.
When you're 30-something and 40-something and 50-something, what the fuck are you still living in your mama's shadows and whether your mother wants to approve of your life or not? Your mama asking your permission to approve of her life? No.
See, that's...
but let's be honest. When do you become an adult? Because we're all somebody's child.
Exactly.
We'll always but be when somebody's when child do you become an adult and say,
make your own decision
for my happiness,
this is what it is.
And your happiness doesn't have to govern my satisfaction in the sense of we need to date. Mm. No, my thing is be happy where you are in you and your decisions. And let not your decisions be governed necessarily by a religion
outside
and a community of people who would stone you any damn way. In the meantime, they themselves struggling with not paying their tithes and offering.
Hallelujah.
Because you saw that new shoes that you need to get, or you saw that new bag that you need to wear with that dress. So therefore, I'm not going to give my full offering this week. I'm going to give
5%.
5%. You know, we struggle, if we want to say it, we struggle daily. But I don't think, for me, I struggle. I would say that I have conflicts within myself to be the best me. Mm-hmm. And in that conflict, it's whether I desire to read more books, it's a conflict. I want something that I haven't created a habit to do. Mm-hmm. For instance, you have a car and you said to yourself, boy, the dashboard says that I need to change this oil by this week. I don't get around to it. 2 weeks later,
so you look at it again.
You see what I'm saying? Mm. So in that space where you desire something but never made the time or create the habits to get it done, that's your conflict. That's not the devil trapping you. That is your conflict within.
Yeah, I guess I would relate to, relating back to what she's saying, like how she's bringing back, she would say like her, cause like how my two things that I've said it, y'all heard me say before, time and communication, those are two things I'm not compromising on.
You can't build a relationship
without it. But her past relationships, it wasn't stress. Like, I see you when I see you. I talk to you when I talk to you. But my whole thing is, you can't, if you're not, you got to look at it. You ain't in those anymore. It didn't work. So you're moving on. So it's like.
So how old are you when that happened?
But here you here now, and someone that wants to spend time, he wants to get to know you again in order to build something. And your excuse, you keep going back to, you know, oh, I'm not used to this. And I hate that, because it's not the first woman I've heard say that. I'm not used to it. It's like, okay, you're not used to it, but you're not there no more. You're right here. You're right here. So it's like, what do you want me to do? I can't change which was. I'm here right now. I'm trying to show you different.
Hello.
So it's just like, it's just frustrating. It's like, I can't stand that. Oh, please.
So obviously, if you're not used to, the things that you're used to that you didn't like because you wasn't getting the full amount of affection and time and whatever else, there had to be a reason why that other relationship didn't work. Right. Whether you walk away or they walk away. Mm-hmm. Obviously, so if you don't know your patterns within your relationship with others, you're bound to repeat them. And you can't tell me, say, you're not used to this. And if this is, you know, I'm not used to somebody buying me dinner. Okay. Is you pretending to be shy or you just broke? Because some people play like, you know, I'm just going to have a salad. No. Because I said we're going to go half and half. Don't mean that you ordered a $10 salad. Meanwhile, my steak and potato is $50.
Let me taste, George.
Yeah. You know, so I think we tend to carry over in our lives different habits. And some of those habits are learned from our parents, whether they were in the picture or not. Some people have daddy issues. Some people have mommy issues. Some people have both. Some people are independent of their situation and says, well, I will never become that, whatever that is. And they strive to be better than where they came from. Mm. So in their relationship with whoever they have in relationships with, and whether it's a friend or whether it's someone intimate-wise, they can say, I prefer to be treated this way. One of the things I learned over the years, how you allow someone to treat you, that's how they're going to treat you.
Right.
So like some people says, I don't like cursing, then I will then try to curve. It might slip out, but it might curve based on who I'm around.
Right.
I'm not going to go stand before a body of people in the sense of giving a public speaking and cussing a motherfucker and bitch ass. You're not going to.
Your message is lost.
Yeah. So for me, it's where in that space where you're getting to know someone, you got to be open to tweak certain things.
Right.
Someone that says, listen, I would like more time with you. Okay, let me look at my schedule and see what I can do.
Go ahead. Oh, yeah.
I know, I'm stepping on toes. Hallelujah. But I think that is the thing where people don't get. So now, the person walk away from you because they're tired of your bullshit. And then 6 months down, you know what? Winter coming soon.
It wasn't even 6 months. It wasn't 6 months. It was a couple of days. A
couple of days later.
I want you back.
Eh.
Like,
hello.
I want you back. But like, I'm here trying to be present, telling you, I'm trying to spend time.
And I think that goes for a lot of people who
it's like
is frustrated on the dating scene.
Like I don't know what else. It's like, it's the first time. I keep saying it 42 years, but it's not. I haven't been dating since 42 years. But I'm just saying, in all my dating years, I've never had to look at a calendar to make time for somebody. It's not me making. It's me having to accommodate her schedule.
I'm schedule
like,
you in.
Like that's ridiculous. I've never ever had to do that, and that's a problem for me.
And you're not.
But
you're not even dating Beyonce.
And that's a problem. Like, that's weird to me. Like, especially in the beginning, I could understand if later on, you know, yeah, we in it, and like maybe you got a promotion and you're down, your time is even more, you know, stretched.
Yeah.
All right.
You're doing live concerts.
Yeah, shut up. You're not Beyonce. And so I could.
But I'm just saying, people who are out there doing business like that, they work on a schedule. Mm-hmm. They have a calendar, or they have a personal secretary that govern their time, because their time is important. But so much so that if you think about it and look at their schedule, they schedule time for family. Because it's important to them.
Yeah, she got little Blue Ivy and two twins, so she had to have time to do something.
Exactly.
Hello.
To create them too.
So you had time for something. And with her, you know, her thing was She had a lot of things planned before I came in the picture. Okay, but I'm in the picture now. So
obviously you wasn't in the picture. You was on the sidelines.
So, and I
trying to be reconsider whether or not I should reschedule my calendars to put you on it.
Bye, job, bye.
But you was all about the Jesus.
He's like, shut up.
Oh, glory.
Whatever.
But if it's sex you want, you can buy a dildo.
It's not the same. You know, it's not the same.
Okay. But don't interrupt somebody else's life.
True.
Just to use them to satisfy your sexual desire. There's a whole lot of blow-up dolls and other shit going on in the world. You can use it. I think it's important for folks not to get people's hopes up and then let them down because you're selfish. You know, if you're saying that we're going to work together, again, we're not only talking about sex. Right. Me and you don't necessarily have sex. We have a verbal conversation that is stimulated. Mm. At the end of the day, we're not doing it over the phone or through text messages. Some days we have to sit down on top, and sometimes it's not about the camera. It's about us spending time watching a movie, watching Timothy.
We haven't been on here in a minute.
Yeah. So, you know, I think that for me is understanding, even when we're talking to my sister about the dating scenes. Yes, she's dealing with the options are few in her mind because she's not going to date some man in their 30s with flip-flops and socks going to the fucking supermarket. I mean, you're too old for the bullshit. You're 35, 40, and your pants sagging down your ass and don't expect me to say, damn, you got a fatty. Because at the end of the day, you're exposing yourself like a woman. And I'm not saying a woman expose her ass. I'm saying when a woman takes pride in her shape and she knows she's shaped good, she automatically has a swag about when she walks. And you see the badunkadunk just going back and forth.
Did you say badunkadunk?
Yes, her badunkadunk. Now you find these dudes, they're in the gym working out their ass more than they're working out their upper torso. You know, you're not doing bench press. You're doing squats. And you won't tell me, say, you're a top. Brother, please. Because at the end of the day, let's be real. As I said to you before the camera came on, I think we tend to follow the norm. So somebody who will get in certain attention, you tend to emulate or copy that which they're doing. You know, everybody at one point in time, back in the days, used to be big up top and had a belly, skinny legs. Because everybody had the same routine of working out. Mm-hmm. It's the same thing with social media. We tend to, you know, want to date a certain kind of person. But you can't keep that person. And I'm not talking about just body-wise. I'm talking about characteristics. Mm-hmm. You know, somebody might meet you and go, oh my God, your breath of fresh air, you talk your truth.
But they don't know how to keep their breath of fresh air.
Can't deal with it. And not analyzing themselves to say, boy, all right, I'm feeling her.
Get it.
How I'm feeling her or him. How do I go about expressing myself to them to let them know I'm really interested? I might know it's like playing hot potato. I don't know how to hold you good yet, right, but I'm willing to not let you go.
Blow on you.
Yeah.
So speaking of blow. Whatever. Y'all know what I meant. Whatever. Yeah, it's just, I mean, like, I haven't given up hope. It's just annoying. It's like you're saying, don't get someone's hopes up. You understand? Yeah.
Which is why I said to you, don't give them the tongue.
Dude, can you like...
Well, whether kissing or otherwise, don't give them. Let them open their mouth and share their story and tell their truth. And whether it's 6 months, and yeah, you could feel the heat and you feel the passion and I want to touch it. No. I'm giving you 6 months of going out on brunches and I'm not inviting you. You're not spending the fucking weekend by my house. Because that's temptation waiting to happen. So then you go, I slipped and fell all in the juices. No, stop it. Let us focus on getting to know your story, my story. Figure out whether or not we can come together as one. Like 40-something, how many more fucking dates you going to need to go on in order to say, all right, I need you for the next 20 years of my life or the next 50 years of my life? Because listen, most of us don't live past 70-something. So if you think about it, you got 30-something years.
I'm trying to, like, look.
30-something, another 30 years to get your shit together. Another 30 years, you'll be 73. You know, at the end of the day,
and I don't want to be having this conversation.
At 73, you can imagine.
I won't be having this conversation.
Me and you.
Take my dentures.
You remember when you had to go up on a date with? No, I think that is too much.
I won't be having this conversation. No, sir.
And how do we train or teach our kids to value common sense? You can have all the fucking degrees in the world. But at the end of the day, if you're dumb, you're dumb. And I find a lot of folks that are... Oh, Lord Jesus. A lot of folks, whether on social media or on the jobs or on the trains, they might come across as very intelligent individual. You know, I went to Harvard and I have my degrees, and but you still are a self-saboteur. You sabotage one relationship to start another only because you cannot keep yourself satisfied personally within, to then receive from that other person the love and the affection that you're getting and be satisfied with that. Because next thing you know, you're moving them out of the way to go, oh, you nice, sir. But you never embrace me in the fullest.
Right.
Because you never made the time. You get to know me and the sex happen and the novelty wears off now, so you're looking for the next high. Other than, let us figure out how many other ways I can get to know you. Just like Janet Jackson or some of these artists, they reinvent themselves. You got to reinvent a relationship. You can't just sit at home after, all right, we said I do, let's watch TV. No, you have to look at if we're getting stagnant. And some people get stagnant the first 2 weeks.
That's ridiculous.
I know it's difficult. It's difficult for me to change. Then you shouldn't put yourself on plenty of fish or plenty of dick or plenty of ass and saying that you're looking for a relationship, because obviously you were just looking for a hookup.
Basically. And I guess some people don't want to say that because of how it may look.
Tell the truth and shame the devil.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Especially you say you come from church.
Dude, like really?
A lot of folks are on these websites to come from church. It's not just one individual. Hello.
We're not specifically speaking
because. Emil calling him. As a matter of fact, I don't remember.
You don't remember her name? Good.
But Emil calling him. The truth of the matter is, and it's not about her and it's not attacking her, it's every characteristics like her. Mm-hmm. And whether you're in the straight world, the gay world, lesbian world, we need to stand in our truth and know ourselves. Let's go to the biblical stuff where we say, to thine own self be true. I think it was some poet or some Bible stuff. Okay. Think about that. To thine own self be true.
Before you can be true with anyone else.
So if you don't know the truth for yourself, how are you going to share that with me? Why? If I ask you, what's your favorite food? I like you don't know. If you did know, on that first question, what's your favorite food? Oh, I love me some steak and eggs, you know, for breakfast and for dinner. I love when they cook curry goat. Or you can automatically go there and have those kind of, and I think the difficulty.
How was it?
Okay.
The food was good.
It tastes like saltfish. Codfish, yeah. Yeah.
It
wasn't bad.
Yeah, and the chicken, I'm going to leave you three of the chicken wing.
I'm sitting there like, what's up now? Yeah. So before we close, you have any more tips about dating? Any more anything you want to share with the folks? Make sure, if you enjoyed this, make sure you thumbs up this video. If you want to see more of us doing mukbangs together, let us know. This is like a mukbang Vibrant Conversations together. So for y'all who never watched it, I'm going to put a link down below so you can see what Vibrant Conversations is. Because you're like, you know, y'all not eating.
There's some deep thoughts.
So just, yeah.
But we were having some deep food too. The food was good.
Yeah, not bad. It's a lot.
Yeah, it's a lot of portion. The portion was very, just right.
Yeah. So you have any more tips you want to?
Tip number one. Say what you want.
Mean it.
Tip number two, before you say what you want and mean it, know what you want.
Important. Know what you want.
If you want a relationship, you have to be open to everything and attach yourself to no outcome. So I don't know where this is going to go, but I'm going for the ride. I'm trying to get to know you as you get to know me. Let us talk some more. Not, I'm feeling you. Oh, let me send you a picture of my ass. No. Let's get to know the person, not body parts. Know the person internally.
Body parts are not, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Body parts are great, but let's do that 2-3 months down the road. And not just trying to be, you know, some people trying to be mysterious. Like, please. There's no mystery, unless your pussy got 2 lips and 3 tongues.
Pussy does have 2 lips.
Some people don't. If you look at some of it, the shape. I'm talking about this, calling lips. Okay.
Yeah. What don't
some people don't have it. Some people just.
They're just not big. They're just not. They're just,
like,
they're
that not ain't big. Lips then.
That is. It's just not big. Whatever. It's just not big. It's,
maybe you.
There's no pussies. There's
maybe
the
Chinese.
Dude, can you? What if I have? Look. Anyway, whatever.
But no, they're body parts that are not what we would say proportion. So that's what I'm saying. It's but either which way, unless it is different than the rest. I've been there, done that. If you go in one ass, you go in all. I mean, it's the same. You go in, you see. I mean, dick size are different, breast size are different. But let's be honest. You know what stimulates you before you got on the site, right? Mm-hmm. So okay, you know that if what I look like doesn't attract you, then leave me alone.
Right.
Don't hit me up and go, what's up? Because you're bored, because nobody else is paying you no mind. You hit me, how you doing? What you up to tonight? Well, I like your picture. Because you know that's going to stimulate another. Oh, so what
do you like about picture?
Yeah.
Like, yeah, whatever.
So just, let's just not play the games, man. I see people out there, sometimes I look at these websites. Oh, I'm just looking for someone, a gym buddy. Or I'm just looking for someone to smoke with. The intent is that you just don't want to say, I want to
right,
fuck.
Right.
But if you say that, it's your life. Live it to the fullest.
I saw somebody's ad like that the other day. And I was like, I respect it. I'm not interested, but I respect it.
Yes.
Like, I'm just looking to see, but I'm like, I respect that.
And for me,
I respect
you
it.
Get more from your truth. And people respect you for the truth. Other than you come under the umbrella of you're looking for something more serious.
And you're not.
And after the one night or the two nights, I'm now reprogramming myself to walk away from you because I'm now disappointed because you're not standing up to the things that you said you're for.
Right.
You know, so in all things, I hope one of these days we can talk about some other things. Because, you know, someone will get by my damn nerves with the bullshit. We need to really stand in your truth and just say what you are, what you like. And if you are, you know, someone who's celibate, don't give it up. Don't give it up to someone who you think has a good intentions for you until they improve themselves. You know, and that's the thing. Abstinent work sometimes for some. Mm-hmm. Abstinent don't work for everybody. But know what works for you and live in your truth. Mm-hmm. Judge-free zone here.
Yeah. So on that note, we're going to check y'all. We'll see you next. Well, I don't know if we're gonna do another one, but yeah. Hope you enjoyed this. Leave your comments down below, your topics down below.
And get your mukbang on.
Check y'all later.